Did Rama really exist? Is Rama historical? While divinity is a matter of faith, historicity is a matter of existence.
Standing under this tree, let us examine Rama's family tree.
Here is the Surya Vamsa lineage. It starts from Kashyapa and Aditi. In the Solar dynasty lineage, there have been many prominent kings, their names and their deeds corroborating well within the Ramayana text and also with the other legends of India. This corroboration of their deeds across various legends through thousands of years establishes the historicity of this lineage, with close to 51 generations before and 32 generations after him. This lineage can be traced all the way down to the Mahabharata period, wherein Brihadbala, 32nd generation from Rama, takes part in the Kurukshetra war on the side of the Kaurava and is killed by Abhimanyu on that fateful day.
If a character is imaginary, you would not have this length of a tree.
Valmiki composed the Ramayana during the lifetime of Rama himself. In fact, Valmiki was the caretaker of Rama's wife Sita and their children Lava and Kusha.
This clearly places Valmiki Ramayana as a biography, an authentic, credible, historic text written during the time of Rama and validated by Rama himself when his sons narrated to him.
It is for this reason Ramayana is called an Itihasa, meaning it thus happened. In contrast, there have been many adaptations of the Ramayana across the land which have eulogized Rama through the centuries and millennia. These are more in the form of kavya or ballad and religious texts.
If Ramayana is a historical text, why is it called mythology now?
In 1808, James Mill and Charles Grant were appointed to write the history of India as syllabus for the Haileybury College. First they, and later the genre of colonial writers, classified the Indian texts and thought as fabricated trash and drilled it into the minds of Indians that these were mythology. Mill and Grant wrote the history of India deliberately without visiting India, lest they get influenced by its rich culture. In contrast to Mill and Grant, Alberoni wrote about India after visiting India. When Alberoni visited India in 1030 CE, among the many things that he wrote about India, he also wrote in good detail about Rama having been a historical person of this land. 500 years later, in mid-1500s, Begum Hamida Banu, the daughter-in-law of Babur, wife of Humayun and mother of Akbar, commissioned a pictorial Ramayana. This is now housed in the Rydberg Museum, Zurich. Her son Akbar, the Mughal Emperor of India, also commissioned a Ramayana during his rule. This is now housed at the Maharaja Sawai Man Singh Museum in Jaipur.
They all wrote Ramayana not as religious texts, but because they considered it as a historical text of their land.
Ramayana is a geographically correct text. Every place visited by Rama is today identifiable by historic landmarks, commemorative temples and local legends. We all know that Rama's birth is celebrated on Sri Rama Navami, which means that he was born on the 9th day of the lunar month of Chaitra. This shloka gives a detailed star configuration at the time of his birth. From this shloka, we can list out the positions of the planets. When this data is entered into the planetarium software, it gives us the date of Rama's birth as 10th January 5114 BCE. When the date of Bharata's birth is culled out and entered into the software, it gives us the date as 11th January 5114 BCE at 5:30 AM. It is indeed interesting to note here that this time calculated is exactly 16 hours from that of Rama's birth as calculated by the same software. The text also mentions that Bharata was born 16 hours after Rama. On the eve of the coronation of Rama, King Dasaratha calls in his courtiers and discusses the planetary configuration of that evening and states that they do not augur well for him, and he would like to transfer the reins of the kingdom to Rama. King Dasaratha informs Rama about the malefic effects the star configurations were going to bring upon himself, and hence asks Rama to take over the kingdom. This configuration, when entered into the software, gives us the date 4th January 5089 BCE. The elapsed time, as calculated by the software, between the event of his birth to his pre-coronation event is 25 years. This tallies well with the age of Rama as mentioned in the text. The dates thrown up by the planetary software are internally consistent with the sequence of events of the Ramayana legend.
Advancement on science and technology is now opening new possibilities of exploring the past. What looked like impossible a few years ago, such as fixing a date for the events mentioned in the lifetime of Lord Rama, can now be done easily by using a planetarium software.
The veneration of Rama has not been limited to India alone. The Egyptian pharaohs called themselves Ramses of the Solar dynasty, which seems to be a derivative of the name Rama and the Suryavamsa dynasty. In the east, in Thailand, the kings of the ruling Chakri dynasty take on the title Rama. The present king is Rama the IX. This emphasizes the spread of the glory, effulgence of Rama across civilizations, the world over, and brings forth the stature in which Rama was held across the globe through the times.